The composer of this very popular song in Raga Yaman Kalyani was the guardian saint of the Vijayanagara Empire and was said to have spiritually dominated the empire from 1470 to 1539. The Kulaguru to the royal family, he was closely associated with the rulers in their conquests and governance. He also actively spread Vaishnavism to Kalinga and Bengal. He was also the guru of Purandara Dasa. Who are we talking about here?
You're listening to Ascharya.
Vyasaraja was born with the name Yatiraja near Mysore in 1460. Sometime before his birth, when his parents were still childless, they were on their way to Kashi. Suddenly, his father caught a fever and died shortly after. His distraught mother went to the nearby matha to arrange her husband's last rites and take their permission to commit sati. "Wait," said Swamiji Sri Brahmanya Tirtha, a member of the matha. "Why should you die when your husband is still alive?" She turned around and, as he had said, her husband woke up before her eyes. Certain that the Swami had performed a miracle, Yatiraja, their child born sometime later, was given in gratitude to the matha. As a young boy, Yatiraja displayed excellence but found it difficult to adhere to the strict discipline of the matha. One day, unable to bear its imposing rules, he ran away. That night, as he slept under a tree, he had a divine dream in which Narayana comforted him. "Your life will be very fortunate, but you must return to the matha," he was told. Heeding the dream, Yatiraja returned to the matha. Eventually, he took up sannyasa and was named Vyasatirtha. Vyasatirtha then moved to Kanchipuram, a hub then for scholars, to study the various religious systems dominant at the time: Advaita, Visishta Advaita, Bhata and others. Then he went to Mulbagal in Karnataka, another important knowledge center, to study the Madhava Shastras. He even spent 12 years at the Tirupati Devasthanam, supervising and doing puja till the anointed young Archaka could come of age. These early years of gathering knowledge and acquiring experiences would prove invaluable in later days. Having become an advisor to some of the kings under the Vijayanagara Empire, Vyasatirtha then moved to its capital Vijayanagara and worked with its rulers for the betterment of the kingdom. Vijayanagara was located at what is believed to be Kishkindha, the land ruled by Sugriva, where Rama spent 6 months with Lakshmana and Hanuman. On Vyasaraja's instructions, 732 vigrahas of Hanuman were installed throughout the empire. The area is full of Hanuman temples to this day. Vyasaraja had an especially close relationship with Krishnadevaraya, the most famous king of the empire. Once, Krishnadevaraya was faced with an astrologically dangerous time, Kuhu Yuga. In this time, the emperor of the kingdom would face a fatal situation. To save him, when the time came, Vyasaraja sat himself on the throne and declared, "Everyone, see that I am now the emperor of the kingdom." Just as he did this, a snake appeared and lunged towards the throne. Using his yogic powers, he was able to fend off the snake, which disappeared as the designated time for the yuga ended. And of course, he walked off the throne. It is because of this incident that Vyasatirtha was given the title Vyasaraja Tirtha. Vyasaraja was a proponent of the Dvaita Siddhanta, the philosophy of Madhavacharya. However, despite his scholarly attainments and command over Sanskrit, he believed that the truth in the Shastras should be accessible to all. He started the Haridasa movement in Karnataka, writing songs in Kannada and disregarding the caste barriers to knowledge that existed at the time. The Yantrodharaka Hanuman Stotra, one of his most famous compositions, was written in a temple in Hampi where he used to meditate. It still exists. He preached the reality of the world as opposed to the Advaita and Visishta Advaita philosophies that were also dominant. encouraging people to pay attention to the material world they were in and motivating them to defend the empire from external forces. He founded many agraharas to foster learning and dharma. Vyasaraja was a multi-skilled genius, a scholar, the chancellor of the Vijayanagara's Imperial University, a statesman and diplomat, a composer, the founder of the Haridasa movement and the Rajaguru of the empire. Yet, despite these many accomplishments, he is perhaps most famous for the Shishyas he fostered. He was the guru to giants of the Bhakti movement, Purandaradasa, Kanakadasa, Venkatadasa, and others who were responsible for the renewal of spirituality among their people. We have already heard Purandaradasa's story. Next episode, we will hear the story of his other disciples. This is Sukanya signing off. Thank you.